In my previous video, I explained why you need a landing page while driving external traffic to your Amazon listings. In today's video, I'm going to show you how to make a landing page in Canva that is similar to the websites of Britney Spears' memoir, which is one of the Amazon bestsellers nowadays. Yes, Canva websites is free and no coding is required, so you can easily make landing pages like this one for your KDP books. In addition to that, since one of the purposes of having a landing page is collecting customer data, as they do here, I am also going to show you a free way to collect emails on your Canva landing page. All you need is a Canva free account and a Google account to do this. If you have these two, let's do it step by step. Before we start, let me clarify a confusing point: the distinction between a homepage and a landing page. A landing page is a single web page that is created specifically for a digital marketing campaign. It is designed to capture information from potential customers in exchange for something of value, such as a promo offer, newsletter, or an ebook. In short, the sole purpose of a landing page is to keep the visitor focused on the offer and take a specific action. On the other hand, a homepage is the main navigation page of a website. There is often a navigational menu at the top and a footer at the bottom. It may include links to other pages on the website, such as product pages, contact pages, about pages, or blog post pages. So, after this information, if you check the Woman in Me website again, I can say that this site is somewhere between being a homepage and a landing page. I chose this site as an example because most audiences of my channel publish books on Amazon, and having a landing page similar to this one will fit their needs perfectly when they drive external traffic. The main goal of this page is to drive the traffic to the e-commerce website with this Order Now call to action button here. And the second goal of it is to collect emails by offering a free ebook here. Normally, a perfect landing page encourages its users to take only one such action to avoid the confusion of choosing. However, there are no exact rules. The most important is your needs. I will show you both how to make a click-through landing page and a lead generation landing page in Canva, so you can test and decide what works better for you. Okay, let's do it. On the Canva homepage search bar, type websites or click websites on the navigation menu here. Canva offers a variety of templates. Anything with a crown on it is for pro users. Anything without a crown is available for anyone. You can also create a blank web page and start from scratch by clicking here. Since I am looking for something close to the Woman in Me website, let's check if they have any website templates for a book or an author. To find what you need faster, for example, you can even search like book websites here. Okay, some free options match our needs here. I think this one looks good. Let's try this. Click Customize this template. It will open in a new tab. Okay, as you see, it's a quite good website template for a book. On the first page, there is a picture of the book cover and links to purchase the book. As an example, you can put your Amazon KDP link here. I will show you how to do it soon. You can write something about your book on the second page, like the one on the second page of the Woman in Me website, or you can show the inside pages here, if it's a low content book. On the third page, if your book is available on other websites, you can put their links or the links of other Amazon marketplaces, like the UK or Canada, depending on your target audiences during your marketing campaign. On the fourth page, you can put some customer reviews if you already have some on Amazon or other websites. On the fifth page, you can put some information about yourself, and so on. As you see, this template is more like a homepage. Since I aim to show you how to make a landing page in Canva today, I will keep just the first two pages and delete the others. So you can delete the pages that you will not use by clicking here. Okay, now there are only two pages here. So I will design the first page as a click-through landing page and the second page as a lead generation landing page to collect customer emails. Everything is editable here. For example, you can change the text by double-clicking on it. Also, you can drag photos from the element tabs or upload your own. If you look again at the website of The Woman in Me, it has two different background colors in its layout. On the other hand, ours has only one background color. However, you can change the original layout by clicking Layouts on the left menu. You see, there are different options here. I think this one with two background colors looks fine. The book cover has disappeared, but no worry. I will show you how to put your book cover on a mockup now. Click Apps, then search Mockups, and click. Then click on the Print tab and browse the free book mockups in the gallery. This one without a background looks good. Select it. Then you can choose an uploaded image or existing Canva design to use in your mockup. If you want to use a new image, select Upload to upload a new JPG or PNG file. I already uploaded my cover image here, so I will drag and drop my file into this mockup. Okay, here it is. As you see, there are some white spaces as the ratio of my file is different than the mockup. If you click Edit and then Fill, you can fix this problem. Okay, now I will increase the size and place it in a similar position to the original size. It looks good, right? You can also find different book cover mockups on different sites, upload them to Canva, and use them on your Canva website. Now, let's change the background colors. On the right side, I will choose this color, as it is similar to the one that is used on my YouTube channel page. Since I will use black for the left side's background, white is better for the text. Let's change the background of the left side to black now. Okay. Let's also change the call to action button's background. As a final step, I want to change the text fonts. Okay, all looks better now. Now let's change the text of the heading, subheading, and call to action button. If you are doing this landing page for your Amazon KDP book, try to make something like the Woman in Me website. I mean, change the call to action button here to order now and put your Amazon KDP book link. I prepared something like this one, as I want to help you learn how to create a landing page that drives external traffic to your Amazon listings. In this video, I will put Canva online landing page builder link here, so you can click and check it in detail. Let's do it now. Select the text box you want to link. Right click and then click link. Paste the link here that you want to redirect. Now let's check what our site looks like. At the top right, there's a preview button. Click on this to see how it looks and test out the link. Okay, it works well. I will publish this site and put the link in the description, so you can check how it looks after this video. I think the desktop version looks good, but let's check how it looks on mobile. Oops, unfortunately it doesn't look good, because the book is supposed to appear under the header and click to action button. Let's try to fix it. Okay, I think the book mockup extends on the left side responsive column. That's why it happened. Let me make it smaller and check the preview to understand. Okay, as you see, it's okay now. If you want to use this or similar layouts, you shouldn't extend the image to the edge of the left or right side responsive columns. So, I will delete this mockup and try to find another book mockup which will look better on this layout. Open the Canva homepage in a new tab. Then type book mockups on the search bar. This one is free. Let's check it. I think it's good. Let me delete all the unnecessary details quickly. I only need the book mockup here. Now we can drag our cover into the new mockup. I will use the black one this time. I think this will look better. Okay. Select the mockup and then click Group. Then right click and copy. Now we can paste this to our website. Turn back to the website tab and paste it. Let me arrange the size and position. Okay, let's check the preview again. Okay, it looks much better now, right? Now our click-through landing page is ready. I will publish and put the link to this site in the description. So, please check if it works well on both desktop and mobile and give me your feedback in the comment section. Thanks in advance. Now let's create the second page. This will be a lead generation landing page and we will collect email addresses with Google Forms. To make things faster, I will copy the format from the first page. Firstly, change the background to black and delete the text here. Then, select the text and call to action button on the first page, duplicate, and move all to the second page. After that, replace this with something that will encourage your audiences to subscribe to your newsletter. Something like this. Let's add an email icon from the Elements menu. It looks better now. Okay, now we can create a Google form. To create a Google form, go to drive.google.com and sign in with your Google account. For your information, Google Drive is completely free to use. When you open your Google Drive account, click the new button on the left corner. Then, click Google Forms. Okay, I want to keep it simple. The title is Self-Publishing 201 Newsletter. The description is, get access to advanced Amazon KDP tips and tricks that I don't share anywhere else. Okay, now we can start adding our questions. Click Untitled Question, so name is good for the first question. Short answer is okay here. And don't forget to turn the required option on for this question, because you should know your customer's or audience's name. Click Add Question. Let's write email for this. Short answer is okay here, and make it required because it's our main purpose to make this form, right? You can keep it like this or add more questions. I will add one more question, and it is, do you publish books on Amazon? This time multiple choice option is okay here. Option 1 is yes, option 2 is no. I know most of my audience publishes books on Amazon, but maybe some of you do not. So I can filter my audiences accordingly before sending an email related to Amazon KDP. I think it is better to keep the required option off for this question. Okay, lastly, to avoid any privacy problems, it's better to get a confirmation from people that they agree to receive email from us. You can write something like this. Do you want to subscribe to our newsletter? This time let's make it checkbox. Option 1 is yes, only one option to choose, and make it required. Okay. You can customize this form from here. I want to change this purple color to my brand color, the orange one. Let's turn back to Canva and click color, then double click the color you want. Here you can copy the hex code and then paste it into Google Forms. Okay, better now. You can also add a header to your Google Form. As I said, I want to keep it simple, so I will skip it. The recommended Google Forms header image size is 1600 by 400 pixels, and you can prepare it easily in Canva. Okay, our form is ready. Up here, you see a responses tab. This is where you will see all the responses of the people who fill out your Google Form. If you click here, there is an option to get email notifications for new responses. Let me show you the settings also. You can check them later. I will keep it like this. Just be aware that for the collect email addresses option, if you choose verified, respondents must confirm their Google account email address gets collected with their response. I think this may reduce the motivation of people, so I don't want it. Okay, we are almost done. We just need the URL of this form and put it in our call to action button in Canva. Click on the send button on the right corner, then click on the second tab and copy the link. You can shorten the link if you want. Let's head back to Canva. On the second page, right-click on the subscribe button and click the link. As we copied this from the first page, delete this link and paste the Google Forms link here. Okay, now click preview to test it. Okay, it works very well. Now test it. Let's fill the form and submit. I will put the link to this landing page below in the description, so you can also check how it looks. If you are interested in such content, you can submit your responses and subscribe Self-Publishing 201 newsletter list. I recommend it. You can also customize this area in the settings menu. Now, let me show you how you will see the responses. Go to your Google Drive account. When click responses, you can see the summary and responses individually. You can collect emails manually here by copying emails one by one, or you can export the data into a spreadsheet by clicking here. Also, if you click on the three dots here, you can download the responses as a CSV file. I prefer to download it as a CSV file. When you open the CSV file, it appears like this. Click Data in the top menu, select the first column, click Text Columns, and Delimited is selected. Next, choose comma and click Finish. Okay. As you see, you can copy all customer names and emails from here and import them to your email management tool to send emails, like MailChimp or another one. Now, the final step is to publish this site. Click Preview before publishing and be sure that if links are working and if it looks good on mobile, etc. When you are okay for all, click Publish Website. Okay. As it will be a landing page, no need to have a navigation. And there are three options here. Canva free users can have up to 5 live websites on the free domain. If you upgrade your membership to Pro, you can publish unlimited websites with free domain. Your domain will be my.canva.site. For an on-brand and professional-looking site, you may purchase a custom domain through Canva. Or upgrade to Canva Pro and link an existing domain you own. If you have existing domains that you want to use, Canva Pro users can connect up to 5 domains to Canva. These details may change in the future. So after watching this video, I recommend you test the link on the first page of this landing page. It will direct you to a related page on the Canva website. You can find the link to this landing page below in the description. For a landing page, it is okay to continue with free domain. Hit Continue. Here you enter your subdomain, then you can write something like newsletter after the slash. Then write the page description here. There are options under the advanced settings. It is okay for me like this. Let's hit the publish button. Okay. Now the landing page is live. As I said, I will put the link below in the description. Please check how it looks on desktop and mobile. If you click the link on the first page, you can learn more about Canva websites and start designing yours. Don't forget to check the form, and if you want to join our newsletter to receive advanced tips and tricks, submit your response. I hope this video was helpful. If you think so, make sure to subscribe and like the video to support the channel. See you soon.